Well, hi kids. This week I'm generating with Wand 2.1 in DrawThings. DrawThings is the image and video generator for Mac and iOS. It's free on the app stores and can be downloaded directly from drawthings.ai. The latest updates add support for Wand 2.1 video. There are 4 models in all. And in DrawThings, we also have the quantized version, so it looks like there's a lot more, but it's really just 4. Now there are 2 text-to-video models, a large and a small, and 2 image-to-video models, large and still pretty large, but we're calling it medium. Now the difference is in compute requirements, and that affects their render capabilities, specifically image size and the number of frames. For quality, you'll choose the largest model that fits on your device or your computer. And if you can run the bigger model, that's probably what you want. It's a better model. But of course, the larger and longer the video, the more demanding on your computer and the longer it takes to render. This is not fast. Generating video locally is slow, but the trade-offs are it's free if you don't include the cost of a modern computer in the electricity bill. And of course, when you render locally, it's uncensored. What generates on your computer can stay on your computer. Now let's get to the models. Wand 2.1 14B is a 14 billion parameter model. By comparison, FluxDev is 12 billion. Hanyuan Video is 13 billion, so Wand pushes the bar a little further. And if these next-gen models are already a strain, it's not gonna get easier from here. Once we include the text encoder, they're all about the same size, around 25 gigabytes for the full models to live in your RAM. Now, if you're trying to render at 720p, you'll need 32 gigabytes of RAM on your Mac. Maybe with quantized versions, that could be under 24 gigabytes, but remember, Apple Silicon is sharing its unified RAM with the operating system. So Wand will be a strain on iPad or older MacBooks. Try the 8-bit and SVD quant models to keep the memory as low as possible. Also, shut down Discord and YouTube. You're gonna need all the RAM that you can get. At the top of the list are the full text-to-video model, just called Wand 2.1 14B, and the full image-to-video model called 14B 720p. Now, 14B is the size of the model. 720p is the size of the video. The 2 smaller models include the medium image-to-video model, 14B at 480p. So the same model, but reduced quality. That's not usually the compromise that I want to make. And lastly, a relatively tiny text-to-video model at just 1.3 billion parameters. By comparison, SDXL is 3.5 billion, and SD 1.5 is less than 1 billion. Now the small text-to-video 1.3 billion model is designed to work with just 8 gigabytes of video RAM, but once again, on Mac and iOS, RAM is shared with the operating system and everything else that's running. Now, in DrawThings, we have the option of downloading SVD quant versions. These are created by the developer of DrawThings. They save RAM and render a little lighter, at or near the original quality. There's also an 8-bit version of the 1.3B model. So definitely give that one a try. It's not great with moving people, but it's still a good model for lightweight text to video. Okay, here comes the tutorial. All the models I just talked about are available in the DrawThings model dropdown. Once you pick the image or text model that will fit on your system, DrawThings will download and install all the necessary files. You'll need at least 25 gigabytes of free hard drive space to unpack and install, maybe double that. At the time of this video, Wand Loras exist, but we can't import them yet. This is where I remind you to subscribe if you want to be notified when that update happens. Now, the parameters seem to be really similar for all the Wand models. my step are in the just beach of Ford. I think we're longer videos. And text guidance is in the range of 4.0 to 5.0. My settings are a little lower than what is officially recommended. I think that you can raise the text guidance to 8 or even 12 without much harm. Probably get a more saturated, bolder image quality, maybe better for animation styles. Now shift seems to be necessary, set at around 5 to 6, and maybe higher for longer animations with more frames. The frames per second from one is an awkward 16 FPS, so I think you're gonna need frame interpolation software. But I guess the good news is that we're getting longer animations for the same number of frames. And one renders up to 81 frames. It works well for the large models. They can render up to 720p if your computer can take it. Just grab the big models. They render with the least issues. With the two smaller models, it's recommended to not render higher than 480p and probably keep the number of frames to half. So 32 to 48 frames, that's still 2 to 3 seconds of video. Now your final choice is the sampler. I tried the usual trailing samplers. I honestly didn't notice much difference. I'll probably use DDIM trailing for image to video, and maybe with time, I'll see a preference. Now the small models can render large too, but I see more errors. It's the same general AI problems that hit all small models. They hallucinate, they make weird choices that don't look right, and they lose coherency faster. Now the big deal of one, of course, is image to video. Just add your image to the canvas, either drag and drop or use the image import button at the bottom of the canvas. I trim the image by going to export and I choose visible only and copy, and then I can paste the trimmed image back to the canvas. You want to make sure that the image completely covers the render area so we don't trigger in painting. And I make sure image to image is switched off. I want strength at 100%, no image to image. Now after a few minutes of rendering, we'll start to see a preview of the frames showing the progress of the render steps. And eventually the preview will be clear enough to represent the full length animation. This is a new quality of life feature in DrawThings. It's not wasting any render time, but we can see problems in the renders long before it finishes and abort if that's necessary.
Let's go.
Now, prompting in WAN uses a T5 encoder like Flux and SD3.5, but WAN is bilingual, English and Chinese, and by comparison, I think it prompts better than Hanyuan Video. I think it understands the subject and can keep track of attention items, that is, the things that are mentioned in the prompt. For text to video, try describing the subject, doing an action in a location, as it appears in the first frame, just like you would for a normal text to image model. Then describe the actions that you want to see in the video, in as few words and as directly as possible. Now in a longer animation with more frames, I could chain a few instructions one after the other, just sequential sentences, but the longest we're getting is about 5 seconds. And the last sentence of my prompt is any of my camera movements or video format style. Now for image to video, I think it's basically the same, but I'm not sure you really need that full scene description at the start. The image is going to carry a lot more weight. Any text descriptions might confuse the model, it might try to introduce more of those things. So go easy. For more complicated scenes, I describe what's necessary for the action prompts to make sense. So if I want to use it, I'm mentioning it in the starting screen description. As long as the object is already in the scene, it seems possible to control it with a prompt. Maybe not super accurate, but affecting it. But introducing new things that are not in the original frame, like hands or anything that moves into the frame, that doesn't always blend smoothly or look natural. Now I got good results with a clean headshot and prompting for expressions. I almost feel like this could replace a LoRa or a face adapter and save me a lot of headache. If you're working on a graphic novel or a visual novel computer game or really any creative narrative project where you just need the same person wearing the same clothing and hair making different expressions and you need that again and again and again, this might save you. It's really good. The quality is good enough to make different but consistent seed images. Now we can't create dialogue or lip sync animations and draw things, but we can create the starting frames for any of the online video generators that can do lip syncing. It's the same idea as with the graphic novel, you just generate an expression video first, or maybe rotate a camera angle to get different, face angles. And you don't need to mess around with mood board or with Redux. It's actually the same person in the same scene. Now this is a new workflow for me. It didn't actually occur to me before until I started using one and saw how well it's working. So I will let you know how this goes.
Do it.
Now let's export the video. After your render is done, we have a history tab filled with all the individual frames. And on the first frame, you're gonna right-click or option-click on the Mac or long tap on iOS, and you're gonna select multiple. Now in this mode, you're gonna select all the frames from the sequence. Mac is a simple shift-click on the last frame, but iOS needs you to click on each frame. When they're all selected, long tap or option-click or right-click and select export. If you choose a video, the frames are collected and exported at 16 frames per second. If you choose image sequence, each frame will be exported as a PNG and numbered. And then you can import them into your video editor or use QuickTime to open the image sequence and save at ProRes quality for editing. Now I sometimes have problems if I try to export frames from more than one session. When I run a batch, all of those frames will export as one sequence or one video. But if I select frames from a previous session, the exporter will sometimes scramble the order of the frames from two or more sessions. So I recommend that you export as you go and delete the projects often because video will just suck up all of your hard drive. Now that's all I have time for, so I hope you had a learn. Please give the video a like if you think it's useful for others. In the next weeks, I'm expecting more video updates for Draw Things. We should be getting one model imports, hopefully a fast model would show up, that would help. And LoRa imports for Draw Things. I'm not sure if I need LoRa training when image to video works so well, but if I find a one LoRa trainer, I'll let you know. Also, an image-to-video Hunyuan model is coming, probably very soon. And I think some acceleration and caching methods are also coming. That should help speed up the rendering with all of these heavy models. So subscribe to get the updates in your feed. I'll see you next time.